टार्क इज नथिंग बट टर्निंग इफेक्ट. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मूव एनी बॉडी इन अ ट्रांसलेटरी मोशन वी नीड टू अप्लाई द फोर्स. सिमिलरली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रोटेट एनी बॉडी वी वॉन्ट टू अप्लाई अ टार्क. लेट मी एक्सप्लेन वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस. लेट अस कंसिडर ए मेटल रॉड. लेट यू हैव fixed it at one end. Now you want to let the length of this rod equal to something like L. Now you want to turn this body. So if you want to turn this body, obviously we have to apply a force. If you apply a force like this, then the body starts turning. So it is not the force alone that turns the body, it is also the location that where do you apply the force. Say for example, if you have applied the force here, body will definitely turn. Suppose if you have applied the force here, the same force, it becomes little bit difficult for the body to turn. It won't turn that much easily like it was happened in the earlier case. Suppose if you have applied the force here, it becomes even difficult to turn the body. Suppose if you have applied the force here, it even becomes difficult to turn the body. Let us say you have applied the force at this location. Whatever may be the force that you apply, body will never turn. Why? You are applying the force on the axis of rotation itself, therefore body is not going to turn. So if you want to turn your body, there is a basic rule to turn your body. Of course, we need to apply a force. That force shall be applied away from the axis of rotation, isn't it? If you apply on the axis of rotation, body will never turn away from the axis of rotation. So to study what is the impact of the force depending on where do you have applied the force, we define a term called torque, a Greek word which means actually turning effect. Torque or turning effect is defined as the force, shown with the letter tau, the force applied multiplied by perpendicular distance from axis of rotation, perpendicular distance from axis of rotation. So if you have taken a body like this whose length is equal to L, you want to rotate about this body. If you have applied a force like this, if the length is L, from this point the perpendicular distance is L itself, so the torque is nothing but equal to F into L. If I have taken the same situation, say for example, next time I have applied the force F here, where this distance is only half of the length of the rod, then the torque dash will become F into L by 2. Therefore, the torque is less in the second case. As the torque is less, rotation is also less. Why do we need this torque? The rotational motion is opposed by moment of inertia. Like mass opposes the translatory motion, moment of inertia opposes the rotational motion. So to overcome that moment of inertia, we need to apply not only force, we shall apply the force away from the axis of rotation. That's why we need a torque. You can simply try it. Look at the door, any door. Have you noticed that door handle is, at the edge of the door? Why? You have to keep it at the edge. What happens if you keep the handle of the door at the beginning of the door, close to the point where it is rotating? Whatever the force that you apply, the door will never open. That means it won't rotate. That's why it is the handle, the door handle is placed at the edge of the door. Therefore, with a less torque, with a less effort, you can overcome the moment of inertia of the body and put that body in a rotational motion.